Well, good morning, family. Good morning. Let's stand together. I invite you to worship. If you're watching online, let's worship together. Clap those hands. Come on. Hallelujah. Let's worship. Come on.
Come bless the Lord. Come bless the Lord. Draw near to worship. Praise the Lord and bless His name, His holy name, declaring He is good. Come bless the Lord. Come bless the Lord. Draw near to worship. Praise the Lord and bless His name, His holy.
all exist. Who else can rescue me, supply all my needs? They don't exist, they don't exist. Who else can save my soul and make me whole? They don't exist, they don't exist. But you are greater than anything. 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 Come on. Who's bigger than you? Who's stronger than you? They don't exist. They don't exist. Who's more powerful or more in control? They don't exist.
They don't.
Who else can rescue me? Supply all my needs. They don't exist. They don't exist. Who else can save my soul and make me whole? They don't exist.
They don't.
But you are greater than anything.
Every voice.
You are greater than anything.
No one greater.
Cause you are greater.
Declare, church, my healer.
My healer, redeemer, strong tower, my everything, defender, way maker, my savior, my everything. My healer, redeemer, strong tower, my everything, defender, Waymaker, my Savior, my everything, my healer, redeemer, strong tower, my everything, defender, Waymaker, my Savior.
Today belongs to you. So we give you all honor. We lift our voice to worship you. We declare there's no one like you in all the earth. And when you move, Lord, we will see revival. Come on, we set our eyes on Jesus this morning. Come on, church. When you move.
When you move, darkness runs for cover. when you move, no one's turned away.
back to you, Jesus, or back to devotion.
Christ is my firm foundation, the rock on which I stand when everything around me is shaken. I've never been more glad that I put my faith in Jesus. He's never let me down. He's faithful through generations. So why would he fail now? He won't. Built on you.
Together, church, come on.
He won't fail. He won't fail.
He won't.
He won't.
He won't.
He won't.
No, no, no.
He won't fail. He won't fail.
Church, aren't you so thankful that our God never fails? Truly, we serve an awesome God. Amen, church. Well, let's pray together. Father, we thank you this morning that we have the ability to come in and worship you in your house. So we're joining online and we're worshiping with victory. We're praising with victory because, Lord, you've overcome all things, even death, hell, and the grave. And through you, we are overcomers by the blood that you shed and by the word of our testimony. And so today, Lord, we can testify that you are good. And so we use the fruit of our lips, the words of our mouth, to declare your goodness, your greatness. We worship you. We praise you in spirit and in truth. God, we give you all glory, all honor this morning. It all belongs to you. In Jesus' name, everyone say amen. Aren't you so thankful you came to church today? Come on, come on. Where are the thankful? If you're thankful in here, aren't you so thankful for Jesus today? Is anybody thankful today? Oh, come on, just wave your hand at me real quick if you think. I wonder where the thankful people are. I was finna allow you to sit down, but I don't know. I got a thanks in my heart. Anybody thankful in here for Jesus? My goodness. All right, we can sit. Come on, we gotta move on. I don't know about you, but this morning I got a praise in my heart. I'm just thankful to Jesus, to God, for this opportunity to be breathing. Amen. Just thankful to God to be alive today. Come on. We serve an awesome God. Amen, church. Well, I'm so glad that you're here today. It's going to be an awesome day. We just got started, and God has already moved in such a powerful way through our first service. Come on, there'll be nothing less this service. And for some of you extreme churchgoers, we got another service after this at 11:15. You're certainly invited. We'd love to see you there. We have an awesome day in the Lord. I have an announcement for you. The concert we've been talking about, Miles Minnick, it is finally upon us. It is this Friday, and in the announcements you're going to hear that it is from 9 p.m. to 1 a.m., but that time has now changed since FCC and a couple companies have come together to make sure that this concert is free. Come on. Isn't that a blessing that people have come together to sponsor this concert? And for young people, youth, and young adults, or if you're just into this, okay, Miles Minnick is a Christian hip-hop artist, okay? So if you come Friday, it's going to be open to everybody. If you come Friday, you know you're getting Christian hip-hop. So we're going to have a time of worship. There's going to be a message, and then Miles Minnick is going to do about 2 hours of a concert, and we're going to share the gospel that night to young people in our community. Come on, isn't that awesome that we get to share the gospel to young people? Come on, people that need to hear it. It's awesome we have that opportunity. So you're certainly invited, right? But if you know youth and young adults who are into music and they love music, this is going to be an awesome night where he's going to come and minister. He's a youth pastor himself, so it's going to be an awesome night with Miles Minnick this Friday. So make sure if you want to be here, you can be here. The doors open at 6:30, and it is going to be an awesome time of worship, word, and great music and fellowship amongst youth, young adults, and other believers. So you certainly have an opportunity to attend that. We've got so many things going on at this church. I'm so excited about it. Today we have another installment from the series called Brave. I'm so excited about it. So join me. Let's get ready for the message.
Good morning, church family. My name is Jacob. We're so happy that you're joining us today. This Friday is finally the day. Miles Minnick will be here in concert for anyone in 6th through 12th grade. This event is from 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. Grab your ticket now at fcclive.com/registration. Are you seeking community at church? If you're looking to connect, grow, and make lasting friendships, joining a serve team is the perfect opportunity for you. Not only do you get to serve people within our church community, but you also get to meet incredible friends along the way. It's a win-win. And here's some exciting news for our serve team members. Mark your calendars for May 2nd because Sky Zone is shutting down just for us to enjoy together. It's going to be an epic time filled with fun and laughter. But here's the catch. You've got to register to attend this exclusive event. So don't wait. Secure your spot now at fcclive.com/registration. Now, let's get ready for another message from the series titled Brave.
My name is Dr. Aaron Gonzalez, and I'm the head of schools here at Family Christian Center. Our mission statement in a nutshell is developing students in mind, body, and spirit to honor God. Our curriculum is really important. We have a whole scope and sequence, which basically means we have a plan from the time they start from pre-K all the way to the time they graduate. We have a counselor here that helps them as they make the transition into higher education. And we look at it as our jobs to help the parents and partner with the parents to help equip the students so that they're prepared so that when they go out, they're knowledgeable both academically but also spiritually. Our teachers can go anywhere and can work anywhere. They're credentialed, they're educated, they're smart, they have great relationships with the students, and yet they choose to come here. And that's because they have a heart for God and they have a heart for kids. And so our teachers come here every day. It's hard work, but they love what they do. And that's what excites me the best about that. We have chapel every week. In fact, we have chapel for the elementary, and then we have chapel for the middle school and high school. We have praise and worship. We have our youth director who's given the word or the message, and it is awesome. If you're interested in a great quality Christian school, I would encourage you to come and contact our school and just say, I would like a tour. We would love to do that so you could see with your own eyes everything that is happening within our school, and I believe you'll be blessed by doing so.
Good morning, everybody. I hope you're doing well. Isn't it good to be in God's house, everybody? I love being in God's house. Thank you, those of you who are joining us online. We're so glad to have you joining us as well. Well, first of all, I just want to say Dr. Gonzalez is going to be out in the lobby. If you have any questions about our school, I encourage you. He can tell you about our preschool or our K through 12. I got to tell you, we've got a great school, guys. It's you should come in here for a chapel. Oh, dear Lord Jesus. Seeing the kids worship, it starts with the preschoolers. I'm telling you, that'll make a hard heart cry. I'm just telling you. To see those little ones, 2, 3, 4, worshiping God, that's pretty cool. And then we've got our older kids, and Pastor AJ does a great job with our youth. And I'm just telling you, Dr. Gonzalez does a great job with the entire staff. And if you're looking for a Christian-based school, I'm telling you, they've got a really good thing going on academically and spiritually. And so he'll be out in the lobby if you want to come talk to him. I really believe you should consider that. And there's some cool scholarships the state of Florida offers to help parents. And it's not always financially based anymore. The state of Florida's changed when it comes to Christian education, where a good portion of a scholarship is covered for your kids to go to private school now. It's pretty awesome. So they can tell you about that. So That's the end of my commercial. Okay, everybody. Hey, I'm fired up about this series called Brave. And today, I want to look at a character in the Bible that you're very familiar with. And I'm taking popular stories in the Bible and trying to break them down as detailed as we can, looking for things that they did to become brave and how they stood by faith and their challenges of their tests. Because we go through different challenges and different things in our generation. And my prayer is that God would help you to overcome and God would help you to win and you'd be brave in the Lord. Amen, everybody. I want to talk to you today about a character you've probably heard about for years named David. He's a young man and he stood up when all the people around him were afraid and they were cowering. David stood up and he affected his generation and his nation. And how many know he still affects generations today by his testimony thousands of years ago? And my whole point to you is you never know when you do an act of bravery through your God, how many people you could impact by following the Lord and honoring Him with your life. And my encouragement is that you can make it through the grace of God no matter what you're going through today. Amen, everybody. I want to start in 1 Samuel chapter 17, starting verse 20. It says, early in the morning, David left the flock in care of a shepherd, and he loaded and he set out as Jesse, his dad, had directed. And he reached the camp as the army was going out to the battle position, shouting the war cry. Israel and the Philistines were drawing up their lines facing each other. And David left his things with the keeper of the supplies. He ran to the battle lines and he asked his brothers how they were. How you doing? And as he was talking with them, Goliath's 9 foot tall. He's a giant. He's the champion from Gath. He stepped out from the lines and he shouted out his usual defiance, and David heard it. And whenever the Israelites saw the man, they all fled from him in great fear. So these are the people of God, and they're afraid. And sometimes God's people get afraid. But can I tell you, even if you get afraid, you can make it by the grace of God. You just got to keep moving, right? And so we're going to read a cool story that sometimes we go through battles. Sometimes we go through difficulties. Sometimes that we go through hardships. But how many know we can trust God no matter what we're going through today? And so I want to break this down. Now, the first thought is a general thought, and then we'll get a little more specific. But the first thought is we must allow our faith to be stronger than our fears. We've got to work on it. And I told everybody, when things are quiet and good, I said at the last service, you got to store up your nuts. A squirrel goes and grabs his little acorns or nuts or whatever. When things are quiet and good, you need to do everything in your power to make things better for you. Get in the Word, get in prayer, get in church, do everything you got to do. Maybe it's keep your health stronger than ever. Maybe it's save your money, your finances when they're doing well. Man, do everything you can to store up nuts. Okay? I hope that makes sense. Or just to take care of yourselves for the future. Because when you're going through the storm, it's a lot better to have prepared for the storm than to just go through it at that point. And I just want you, if you're in a good season, man, take advantage of it. Don't waste your time at all right now. Thank God for it and be wise with the season at hand. Does that make sense? Please, 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 okay? Okay. Proverbs 28:1 says this. It says, the righteous, who's the righteous? That was not making me feel you got this. Who's the righteous? Come on, we are, because of what Jesus did on the cross and we said yes to the greatest deal, right? We're the righteous, and it says the righteous are as bold as a what? A lion, not a mouse, a lion. There's a lion inside of you by the grace of God. There's something that's bold and courageous. So this 9 foot tall giant comes out and starts shouting. Now, I haven't seen it. I've seen some tall people and people with stilts, but I've not seen a 9-foot giant. How many know that could be intimidating? I mean, shouting at you, yelling at you. I mean, I've seen people this big that have been intimidating when they shout. Come on, praise the Lord, right? And different times we have different giants that are yelling at us. Maybe this morning you're dealing with some financial issues and you have some giants shouting at you. Maybe your health, you're at a point where the doctor says, there's nothing I can do for you. How many of that could be an intimidating statement to hear? Or you have this problem or you have that problem. Or maybe you're dealing with some addictions or maybe you have some fears. How many of those things are real? And it could be like a lion or a giant shouting at you. And David is listening to this giant just shouting at everybody. And it said they were greatly afraid in that situation. And God help us to be led by His Spirit during times when we're afraid. Because sometimes you focus on the giant. You can focus on the giant so much that you stop hearing Jesus' voice. Stop sensing what God's doing. And can you imagine you're looking at this giant, you're looking at his armor, you're listening to how loud his voice is, you're looking at his sword. And sometimes you can be so focused on the weapon that you're not focused on the Lord. And there's a verse in Isaiah 54:17, it says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Man, when I feel like every demon from hell's coming at me, I quote that scripture all the time. I say, no weapon formed against me will prosper in the name of Jesus. I believe that today. I quote the Bible today. Amen, right? So when we have giants shouting at us, how many know there's a negative message being pumped on the inside of us? You're going down financially, or you're going to be sick, and you're going down. You're not going to get better. I mean, just all this shouting, and how many know that negativity is not helping us at all when we're hearing those things? We have to stop listening to the giants in life shouting at us. We have to do what we have to do, and we have to overcome by the grace of God. So let's talk about how do we do that? What are some steps we can do? Well, the first thing I wrote down is, you got to listen to the right things. If you're struggling with your marriage, do not go to a 2-hour movie about two people divorcing. Sweet Jesus. Then you come out, I don't know why I feel even more negative than I went in. I could help you. Don't do it. Okay? If you're having trouble with your marriage, you need to watch a movie that brings two people together, that they connected or they worked through or they overcome. You do not need a story about not coming to an overcoming. You need overcoming stories, not negative stories. You need things that are firewood, right? Come on, in the fireplace where you're like, yeah, I can do it by the grace of God. Maybe you need an oldie like Rocky or something like that. I don't know, but you can make it. Don't listen to negativity when you're having a hard time. You need positive, encouraging things in your ears. Somebody say amen, right? Romans 12:2 says, do not be conformed to this world. Don't be like the world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is the good and acceptable and perfect will of God. This Bible helps me divide from the craziness in the world and what God says. And if you keep renewing your mind with it, you'll know what it says. Come on, you're putting your nuts away for when it's a good day, so you got plenty later on in life. Spiritually, do what you got to do. Put it inside you. I read my Bible every day, whether I want to or not. Yeah, I said it. I'm not taking it back either. Sometimes I want to and sometimes I don't want to. But I've told myself, don't you start complaining. You're going to read your Bible. If you complain, you get an extra chapter. You back that thread up enough, that voice will go away. I promise you that. Okay? So the Bible will give us direction and hope. It's something we pump inside of us. Romans 10:17, it says, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. There are seeds of faith being dropped inside of your heart right now by the grace of God that he can water it and help it to grow and to blossom and to mature. Amen, everybody? So I've got to be intentional to grow my faith. And part of that is listening to the right things. And that's partly, you made that decision today. You're in God's house. You're watching online. I am making a decision consciously to connect with God today. How many know that can't hurt me? That's only going to help me today. Glory be to God. You know, I love Psalms 34:4. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and he delivered me from all my fears. How many think that's an awesome scripture like me? That, glory to God. I would quote that if I were you. If you're going through a hard time and fears, I'd say, I sought the Lord. He answered me, and he delivered me from all my fears. If he could do it for the psalmist, he can do it today. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And I believe God is with me. Amen. All right, let's keep going. I got to do this one more time. I'm getting fired up. All right. Chapter 17, verse 28. Now, you got to watch this. The enemy's very sneaky. The Bible says not to be ignorant of Satan's devices. It says, when Eliab, David's oldest brother, heard him speaking with the men. Listen to this here. Oh, man. He burned with anger at him and asked, why have you come down here? Well, he's down here because his dad told him to go down there. But anyways, why'd you come down here? And listen to this condescending statement his brother says to him. And with whom did you leave those few sheep in the wilderness? Does that sound condescending to anybody else? Why do you have to say few sheep? It's probably more than three, but he's being, would you leave the couple little sheep you got there, boy, right? And then he says, I know how conceited you are. How many know this is getting personal now? I know how prideful you are. And listen to this, and how wicked your heart is. Dang. You came down only to watch the battle. If I'm David, I'm thinking, there ain't no battle here. You're all hiding out. Here's the thing. People you're close to will say boneheaded things. Praise the Lord. Everybody hear what I just said? And that's part of the enemy's tactics, to use people that are close to us to say things that they shouldn't say. Come on, I've said some things I shouldn't say. You said some things you shouldn't say. And other people do the same thing. And David's brother told him, you prideful, arrogant thing, you. You have wickedness in your heart. You just came down here to be a spectator. I can't believe this. Wow. And you gotta understand, I was thinking about the last service. Why would he respond that way? Well, I think the oldest brother responded that way because he had shame. Shame about what? When a giant showed up, everybody's running and hiding. And so the older brother's supposed to hold a certain persona, but he's hiding because of a giant. And so I believe he was responding this way out of shame. And many times people come at you in life stronger than they should because something is going on the inside of them. And they're projecting it onto you. Did everybody hear what I just said? And so David has to move past his oldest brother coming at him. He's done nothing wrong, but it still happened. Here's the third point I put there. You have to learn how to fight off discouragement. You have to learn. Because you know what David could have said? I can't believe my brother said that. I'm out of here. He'd still be crying today. You can shrink and say, I quit. I'm not doing this stuff no more. Come on. You can get an attitude. You can get frustrated. You can just get in that dark despair. But David, it said in verse 40, he took his staff in his hand. He chose five smooth stones from the stream. He put them in his pouch and his sling, and he approached the Philistine. David just kept moving. And one of the ways you fight off discouragement is you got to keep moving. When you stop moving, you lose. Some of you have just it seems like you're consumed with discouragement. keep moving. You lose if you stop. Did everybody hear what I just said? That's when people lose. I remember when I started the church here, somebody came to me immediately. They felt like they needed to tell me this. I'm like, okay. They said, hey, I need to tell you something about Claremont. I said, what's that? The preachers call it the preacher's graveyard. Why are you telling a 24-year-old young man that Claremont is spiritually called the preacher's graveyard? I'm thinking to myself, what are you trying to tell me? This person was trying to tell me, churches don't work here. They all stop and don't work. Well, now it's the craziest thing. You have mega churches all over the place in this community that shouldn't be able to facilitate that many churches. There's churches popping up all over the place around here. So it only did God change that slogan, but now it's like churches just pop up all the time. And by the way, if a new church starts, send them flowers, send them balloons, tell them we're excited they're here. Why? Because, come on, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. We'll take all the help we can get to reach our community for God. So don't be intimidated if somebody new comes. Say, praise the Lord. Everybody hear what I'm saying? That's your heart? Absolutely. Come on. We can't reach them all. We need all the help we can get. So if somebody new comes, praise the Lord. But I remember somebody telling me that at 24, and so I had to get a stiff upper lip and say, I can make it in Jesus' name. We're going to get through this. And 30 years later, here we are by the grace of God, still touching people. But I had to make a choice to keep moving. And you got to make a choice when people say discouraging things that want to take the life of God out of your hope. You got to keep moving. Don't let that discouragement overcome you. You got to overcome that discouragement. Somebody say amen, right? So verse 45. David said to the Philistine, you come against me with sword and spear and javelin, it says there, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you've defied. He said, this day the Lord will deliver you into my hands. He's looking at that giant. You're going down, giant, and I'll strike you down and cut off your head. This very day, I will give the carcasses of the Philistine army to the birds and the wild animals, David says here. The whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. Isn't that good stuff there? All those gathered here will know that it is not by sword or spear that the Lord saves, come on everybody, for the battle is the Lord's and he will give you all into our hands. So this young man looks at that 9-foot giant and says, you're going down. I don't have a sword, but I'm cutting off your head. I'm going to use your sword. And then he looks at all the rest of them that are spectators from the army. Guess what? You're next. Boy, I like his boldness, everybody. And then he says, oh, it's not going to be by a spear or a sword. It's going to be by the power of God. Can I tell you something today? Ask God for his power and his strength over your situation today. Quit doing it in your own strength or your own ability, because how many know ours falls? You know, we need the strength and the grace of God. I was trying to make some things happen this week, and I'm like, oh, God, help me, help me, help me. I was trying to just make some things happen. And it wasn't working out the way I wanted it to. And then all of a sudden, without my efforts, God begins to move in a circumstance or situation. And I was just reminded, it's not your ability, it's God's ability. And I'm like, Lord, I'm going to put this in your hands. You can do it. It's your power. It's your might. It's your ability. I'll put in the effort. I'll do my part. But God, it's all in your hands. And I'm just telling you, some of you, you're like, I can't fight this giant. I don't know how to do this. Man, ask God for his grace and his strength, because it's not a javelin that wins the battle. It's not a sword that wins the battle. It's the Lord that wins the battle here today. Amen, everybody. Come on, glory be to God. Joel 3:10 says this, let the weak say, what? I'm strong. Pastor Rick, that totally contradicts what I'm feeling. Sometimes you're saying by faith that you believe the Word of God is going to deliver you and transform you and come into your situation and make a way where there seems to be no way. We're believing God Almighty to intervene in those situations. The Bible says Abraham called things that were not as though they were. He spoke by faith in his circumstance and situations. Come on. I'd be, if I were you fighting a giant, I'd say, I'm going to make it by the grace of God. I'm going to win my situation by the grace of God. God's going to help me in the name of Jesus. I'd start declaring it. I'm strong because of the Jesus inside of me. Come on, somebody here today. Glory be to God. He's a good God. Verse 48, plane starting to land, everybody. All right. And the Philistines moved closer to attack him. And David, he ran quickly toward the battle line to meet him. And reaching into his bag, taking out a stone, he slung it and struck the Philistine on the forehead. And the stone sank into his forehead, and he fell face down on the ground. So David triumphed over the Philistine with a sling and a stone. Without a sword in his hand, he struck down the Philistine and he killed him. And David ran and stood over him. And he took hold of the Philistine's sword and he drew it from his sheath. And after he killed him, he cut off his head with the sword. Talk about Goliath's very own sword. And when the Philistines saw that their hero was dead, they turned and ran. Come on, that's the word of God today, everybody. Can I tell you the fifth and final thought? Remember, the Lord is with you today. He's with you when giants are shouting at you. He's with you when circumstances aren't for you favorably. He's with you when you're sick in your body. He's with you when you're struggling in your marriage. He's with you when you're going through hardship. He is with you today. Glory be to God. 1 John 4:4 says, greater is he that is in you than he that's in the world. Deuteronomy 3:22 says, don't be afraid of them. The Lord your God himself will fight for you. Hebrews 13:5 says, never, come on, never will I leave you. Never will I forsake you. God is with you. Listen, I've got three kids. The two are older, and they're doing their journey. And I've got one youngin' left in the house. Somebody mess with my youngin', it's on. Everybody hear what I said? Somebody unprovoked goes after my youngin' that's still my, it's on. I'm a preacher, but it's on, baby. You don't mess with my baby, right, everybody? And I'm just telling you, I need to give you perspective. When somebody messes with you, you're his kid. It's on. If I have any protective nature at all inside of me or love towards my kid, it came from God. And I'm just telling you, if I care about my family and my loved ones and my friends, come on, you mess with my friends too. Whoo, it's on. Come on. You all know what I'm talking about. People you love and you cherish. God's like that too. When they come after you, man, it's on. Heaven's about to open. Heaven's about to intervene. Quit doing this in your own strength and your own ability and invite the Holy Spirit and the power of God and watch what God can do when you put it all in his hands. Come on, to God be the glory today. Amen, everybody. Glory be to God. I want to pray for you this morning, if I could, please. Father, today, I thank you that you're with us, you're for us, and today, Jesus, thank you for your kindness, thank you for your goodness, thank you for being faithful, thank you for stories like these with David where he overcame obstacles and even family giving him a hard time, a giant shouting at him, and you helped him to prevail. God, help us to overcome the giants that are already in our lives today. God, help us when a giant's shouting at us in life to win and to overcome, not for our honor or our glory, but for the glory and the honor of our God. So today, God, forgive us when we do things in our own strength, our own ability, and our own wisdom. We set all those things aside and we ask for the strength of God, the wisdom of God, the grace of God. Father, I speak a boldness over your people today and a peace that heaven can only provide. I bless you. And I thank you, Lord, you will help us. You will help us today because the battle is the Lord's. We're grateful that you care about us, you're listening, and you're watching over us today. It's in the mighty and the powerful name that's above every name we pray this in Jesus' name. Come on, if you agree with me, say a hearty amen this morning. Come on, amen. To God be the glory today. We believe your word is true and you are with us today in the name of Jesus. Would you just continue in that posture of prayer? Whether you're in this building or online, would you pray and ask God to touch anybody under the sound of my voice who needs a touch from heaven right now? Would you pray that people that are struggling, God would give them grace and strength to overcome? Would you pray anybody who's not given their lives to the Lord Jesus that would do so today? I'd be so grateful. Maybe you're here or watching online and you'd say, Pastor, I'm not right with God. I want to get right with God. Please help me connect with the Lord. Where do we begin? Well, first, you got to believe that Jesus is God's Son. He died on the cross. He rose again. He's alive right now. If you believe that, you're ready to take the next step is where you invite Christ in your life. You invite Christ to forgive you of your sins. You allow the Lord into your life the best you know how by the grace of God. You're not going to be perfect, but you ask Christ into your life. In a moment, I'm going to lead a prayer. And if you pray it from your heart and mean those words, I believe God will give you a brand new spiritual start. There are people here today and watching that you'd say, I've never invited Jesus in my heart. And today, for the first time, I want to say yes to Jesus. Please pray for me, Pastor. It would be a joy and an honor to pray for you. Maybe you're here and you fit in a different category where you'd say, Pastor, I've prayed at one point. I asked Christ in my life, but I'm not living right. My heart is convicted, and I just need to make some spiritual adjustments. I want to rededicate my life to serving Christ. Would you please pray for me? I want to hit a spiritual reset button, if you will, and regroup my relationship with God right now. I need to make some adjustments, and I need to turn to the Lord. Pray for me. Absolutely. Please pray, everybody, right now. If that's you, and you'd say, Pastor, you're talking to me. I want to give my life to Christ for the first time, or I feel compelled to rededicate my life to God. If that's you, would you just boldly put your hand up high? No one's looking around or gawking, but I just want to see who I'm praying for this morning. Be brave. Don't let fear stop you right now. Let me see who I'm praying for today. Yep, God bless you. Yeah, I'm just going around the room. I don't want to miss anybody. God bless you too today. Yeah, God bless you. Yeah, God bless you. God bless you. Number of people here today. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Just going around the room here this morning. I don't want to miss anybody. Yeah, thank you, Jesus. Anybody else here? I miss anybody? Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Would you pray this with me, especially those who raise your hands? Could we all pray this out loud? Would you say, Dear Lord Jesus, I believe you're the Son of God. I believe you died for me and that you rose again. And you're alive right now. Please come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. Change my life. And help me to be the person you want me to be. And fill me with your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Those who prayed today and asked Christ in your life.
You were just guided through the salvation prayer. If you gave your heart to Jesus today, you have just made the best decision ever. You may be wondering, what's next? Well, we have you covered. Scan the code on the screen to learn about how you can grow in your relationship with Jesus. If you would like to connect with someone personally, you can text FCCGUEST to 97000 to connect with our team. Now is the time in our service where we prepare to give our tithes and offerings. If this is your first time tuning in with us, please feel no obligation to give. This service is our gift to you. If you call FCC Your Church and you want to participate in giving today, you can text FCC Give to 97000, or you can give securely online at fcclive.com/give. I'm going to take this time to pray over our offering. Most holy and righteous Heavenly Father, we thank you for those that are giving today. We thank you for the gift that they are sowing into your kingdom. May you bless it and multiply it so that your will can be done in all things. In Jesus' most holy and righteous name, amen. If you'd like prayer today, you can text FCC Prayer to 97000 and a member of our prayer team will reach out to you. Thanks for joining us for church today. We hope you have the best week ever.